Good morning, guys and girls. Welcome back to the Kingfisher. Today we are going to be talking about a little hot topic at the moment. So it's summertime, it's Couta time. The Couta are on the bite at the moment as we're speaking. So we're going to talk about some Couta trawling setups. Now we've got two for you guys today. One that's a little bit more, let's call it budget orientated, and one that's a little higher end for the guy who really takes his fishing seriously. We're going to start off with the shorter of the two, which is actually what we deem a kayak setup, mainly because of the length, not because of what we're putting in there. Now, the rod we've chosen is a 6'6". Because most of your ski hatches, you do get some that go a little bit longer, but most of them will fit a 6'6" hatch, 6'6" rod. We've gone for the Grand Wave boat rod. You basically get a 6'6" and a 7' in the same line in a 10 kilo and a 15 kilo. Now, depending on what you're wanting to do, the 10 and the 15 are going to be kind of your two choices, and then the length depending on what you're comfortable fishing with. 6'6", beautiful rod, lovely, lovely bend in it. The 10 kilo has got more than enough backbone to pull, but the nice thing is that it's also soft enough that if you wanted to multi-target, multi-species target with it, something like going for snook in the morning and then trawling for couta in the afternoon, the 10 kilo will do that with absolute ease. Onto that, also we have your wire pressed guides in there, so he's not going to get knocked off in the ski and things like that. They're brilliantly strong, they're double footed as well, so it's not like a lot of the cheaper rods that you get have got just a single leg guide. As soon as you try and put them to the ski, it just knocks them off, so going to last a very long time. Onto that, we've got our Sealine 50. Now, I don't think the Sealine 50 needs any introduction. To anyone who's been in fishing or has even seen a fishing magazine, you would have seen this reel. It is the granddaddy, it is the OG, it is the brilliant, brilliant multiplying reel, one that sort of started a revolution of multipliers. Okay, so he's got an aluminium spool, nice quick retrieve on there, decent handle, and the line capacity is a 50 size, so he takes more than enough line. Now, drag wise, you can upgrade the drags in these guys if you really wanted to, but the drag that comes in here is beautiful, it's smooth, it's silky, and it lasts a hell of a long time. I've got one that's probably, she's 10 or 12 years old and she's still going very, very strong. So that is on the ski side. It's also got very, very loud ratchet. So you can hear it even if your motor's running or if you're breathing a bit hard because you haven't been paddling in a while and you're a little bit unfit. That's that guy there. To that, we'd probably put the same line onto both combos. So I'm just going to talk about that in a second. You've got the Kingfisher standard nylon. Now, this is the natural green color. It is almost invisible underwater. It is a phenomenal, phenomenal cost-effective product to put on your ski. Now, the nice thing about that versus something like your Giant Abrasion, beautiful lines and work very well as well. This is slightly thicker per braking strand, which gives you more resistance in the water when it's coming around. Because on the ski, particularly, you don't need very strong line. I'm saying that in inverted commas. You want something that's a little bit thicker per braking strand, so that it gives a lot of resistance on the water. Because getting pulled on a ski is, you take about maybe a kilogram of pressure and you're gonna get towed at speed. So you don't need very strong line, but you do need very durable line. And that's exactly what this is right here. So guys, that's the ski combo. That, like I said, you can get the 10 or the 15 kilo, depending on your preference. But in my mind, the 10 kilo is a lot nicer. It's a lovely rod to fish with. That is the ski combo covered. Now we're gonna go into slightly bigger boy country and guys that are gonna want to spend a little bit more money but get a product that is phenomenal. You've got the Poseidon Couta Light Rod. Now the Poseidon Offshore series also is one of those that's been going for a very long time. It is proved its worth over and over again. They're rods that do not break the bank by a long shot and they perform well, well above that price tag. Now the Couta Light is a 10 to 14 kilo. It's one of those also very good all-rounders that's gonna cover most of your usage. The guys, we literally can't keep enough of these on the floor. We sell so many. It's a beautiful stick. The guys have loved them and they work lovely for Couta or for snook, but for Couta especially, they've got that extra backbone that you really can pull. But if you get into the Sholies like we've got at the moment, those smaller sort of 5 kilos and under, you're still going to actually be able to enjoy the fight. It's not just the broomstick that you're just hauling in with. Now, good Fuji components that we've got throughout. They, once again, double-footed guides, not going to get knocked off. They are hellishly strong, especially if you ram them into stuff. They're going to last very well. We've got a Fuji winch on here as well, which also is not going to crack and get chipped out like that, and the inserts aren't going to fall out and things. It's quality material that you put on here, and it's something that you might pay a little bit more for now, but it's going to last you a hell of a lot more in the long run. Now, onto that, we've got the Saltist Black and Blue 40. This is a bit of a new kid on the block. He's only been out for a shortish while, but he's already proved his worth with both the kayak guys and the ski boat guys. Carbon Tex drag, it's phenomenally smooth and very, very strong. You've got a very big EVA power handle on there. Also, it's slightly longer than your average, so you get a lot more leverage on the pull as you're winding in. Butter smooth, actually ridiculously so. The 40 size is what we go with more on the skis and the boats. You don't need the capacity of the 50, and the 40 just fits nice. It's a nice compact little setup. Having said that, we've got on here 30 pound in the Kingfisher line, and there's probably about, I'd say about 350 meters or so. If you did want to do a bit of a cost saving method for the long run, you can put some braid on underneath, and then you're just topping up say 100 meters at a time. But straight nylon all the way through is more than enough on there, so it's really never an issue to worry about putting on more line or anything like that. You've got more than enough on there. Now, also very loud ratchet that we've got in that setup, so you're going to be able to hear when that coot screams off. And the nice thing about that whole setup, the 30 pound Kingfisher, you really don't need to put a leader on. Some guys do like to have a 10 meter leader, so you've got a spacing point for where you're going to put your downrigger sinker. But with this stuff, you really, really don't. You don't need to. It's more than strong enough. The guys that prefer Maxima, the 25 pound Maxima or 30 pound Maxima will work just as well on here. And yeah, for your average, Ray would have covered this a bit in the baits and things like that. You're going to have your baits out whatever distance that you find or that you prefer. But with these, you control your baits, you control your lures, and you can even put liveys out on this. It's just a multi-purpose setup, both of these, that will work whether you're on the ski or whether you're on the ski boat. So guys, pop into your nearest shop, have a look at these quality Daiwa products and the Poseidon rods, and let's get you on the water and get you catching some Couta. Cheers, guys.